More now, an investigation into the Church of Scientology. Before the break, you heard from several ex-wives who are also current senior leaders in the church. They were upset at their ex-husbands who've left the church and are now making explosive charges. The church's current leader, David Miscavige, has physically abused other members of the church. Now, the women, along with the church spokesman Tommy Davis, called these men liars, say some of them were violent themselves and were removed from their positions in the church. The women say Marty Rathbun, the church's former inspector general, was violent. They also say their former construction manager for Scientology, named Tom DeVocht, never showed any marks on his body from the beatings he said he had from Miscavige. And they called former marketing manager Jeff Hawkins a liar. I talked with all three men to get their responses to the allegations. Tom, you saw your ex-wife basically saying that there was never a mark on you, that she knew every inch of your body, she slept with you every night. She never saw any sign that you had been physically abused.
Right. My comment on it. That's true. I don't know to begin with. Well, first let me tell you this. Out of 19 years, I probably spent 4 years with her out of that entire time.
Why? Because of work, you guys were separate?
I was in Florida. She was in California. I went to New York. She went to Madrid. And I never claimed to have bruises or scars or anything like that to begin with. So it's sort of irrelevant. But she was there and saw me twice get hit by Miscavige.
You say she saw you get hit by David Miscavige?
Yeah.
Because she says you're lying that she never saw anything.
I know. And I don't hold that against her. I know that the pressure she's under, she's going to say that. She's going to say whatever she thinks is right, and she's going to protect the church and protect her eternity.
Essentially, Tom, the church is also saying that you three are colluding together, that you've matched your stories, that you've been working on this, and you're out to destroy the church.
Yeah. Let me dispel that right now. I mean, the last time I talked to Marty, I have not seen Marty since he left. To give you an example, I've not seen him in person. We've not met anywhere. I talk to him occasionally, maybe once a month. He'll confirm that to say hello. How's it going? Mike, I see a little bit more often, live pretty close to him. But
Mike Render,
yeah, sorry. But we don't, you know, I'm not interested in it. I got nothing to do with it. I don't win if it does well. I don't win if it does badly. There's just nothing in it for me at all. I have no intention to reform it, take over it, anything like that. That's not, I'm doing my own thing. I want to get on with my life at, you know, 46. It's time after coming out of there to get rolling. So it's nothing for me. I mean, I got no interest in it.
Marty, you know, the church has also said, well, look, if all this stuff was going on, why didn't you speak out about this sooner? You left the church back in 2005.
Anderson, you know, if you ask any of the guys that were in similar circumstances, there's really a decompression period, and it can go from anywhere to 2, 4, 5, many years, to where you get sort of out from under that mindset that if you say anything negative, or if you go after the church, or if you say something that might be against particularly Miscavige, your eternal salvation is gone forever. And so it takes a while to sort of decompress from that before you're even willing to talk about it to anybody, you know, a friend, a spouse, a loved one, let alone, get up and do something about it.
Marty, when you saw your wife and what she was saying, what did you think?
I had a lot of sympathy and pity. You know, Anderson, you asked about conspiracy allegations that they made. Now, let me tell you right now, the only conspiracy that exists out here is a bunch of people who suffered and experienced an experience that I don't think anybody can really fully grasp unless perhaps they're a war veteran or a prisoner. And it's sort of a mutual aid situation where we're trying to help one another get back on our feet, help one another get back some self-esteem, integrate back into the world, which we've been out of for, you know, until our middle ages. And that's the only type of conspiracy that exists. It's more like an underground railroad as opposed to a conspiracy.
Jeff, I mean, why would, you know, some of viewers have written in saying, why would these current Scientologists and ex-wives be saying all these things and you know, sign affidavits and all have similar stories, basically saying that all of you are lying?
Well, there's a culture within Scientology that you do anything to protect the church. You say anything to protect the church. And they have what they call an acceptable truth, which means a truth, quote unquote, that is that forwards the church's image. Therefore, and it's really another term for a lie. They are willing to do anything. And as I've told you before, when I was in Scientology, I would have done the same thing. If someone had come to me the day after David Miscavige beat me up and said, "Did he beat you?" I would have denied it. I would have said, "No way, that ever happened. Never, never, never." Exactly as Tommy Davis is saying.
You know, one of the difficult things in doing this is, in doing this story, is that there's no physical evidence really on either side. Did, at the time that you say David Miscavige was attacking you, did you ever think about trying to document it with photographs?
No, no. That wasn't my mindset at the time at all. You know, the way you feel when you're inside is that it's all you, it's your fault, that he got mad at you, and, you know, you're put on the... onto physical labor, and you're a pariah, and so forth. And so you don't think about documenting it. You don't think about going to the police. You just think about, you know, what you're being asked to do.
So you never thought about calling the police?
No, no, that didn't even enter my mind. That would have been an instant, I would have been instantly out of Scientology if I had done that. And I didn't want to go there at that time.
Why? You didn't want to leave Scientology?
I didn't want to leave Scientology. I didn't want to leave my wife. It's all I had known for 35 years, so I wasn't ready to cut the cord at that point.
I just want to say one thing. I mean, they must have quoted Tommy Davis 6 or 7 times about each one of us was demoted and then kicked out for all these crimes and all that business. I got to tell you, everybody you interviewed, Amy Scobie, Jeff Hawkins, Steve Hall, Tom DeVock, Mike Rinder, myself, 201, made self-determined decisions and walked out.
None of those guys were kicked out. We walked out. I literally had to tell them, you got a week more to do whatever you want with me. They were giving me confessionals to see if they can fix it so I would stay. And I told them, you got a week more. Week came, I walked up to the gate. I said, open the gate. They wouldn't open it up. I jumped on top of it.
You literally climbed over the gate?
They weren't opening it. They would not open it. I said, look, I'm leaving. I threw my bag over. I got on top of the gate to get over it, at which point they opened, almost crushed my leg. Luckily, I got over. And I walked out. There was no, I was not booted out. I was not told, you're out.
What do you say to people who aren't sure who to believe?
You know, I don't know what to tell them. It's the, it, you know, he said, she said, and they're going to believe what they want to believe. But again, to me, put me on a lie detector test. I'd do that in a heartbeat. You know, it's an odd thing. And they are, again, just trying to protect the church. I've got no reason to do this. Zero. I got nothing to gain.
Guys, I appreciate you talking again. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anderson.
Well, over the past months, we've spoken at length with former Scientology spokesman Mike Rinder. Rinder spoke to us on the record and told us he was abused some 50 times by David Miscavige, but said he wouldn't interview with us on camera because he promised his first interview to the BBC. The church strongly denies what he claims, but once that interview is aired, he says he would welcome an opportunity to come on our show and share his story. Now, once again, we'd like to point out that over the months, we have invited church leader David Miscavige on 360 to address these charges. Through his spokesman, he has declined. That invitation also still stands. You can watch our entire Scientology series on our website at ac360.com. That's where you can also join the live chat, which is now underway.